Hello guys, me Carlos Santos, aka Happy Car 9, and welcome to another edition of F1 2018 Career Mode. So here's the rest of the highlights from season 3. So some of the races might go not so well, but while others it might be a breeze. So fortunately enough, I did finish well in the points, but at the end of the video, you'll see where I end up in the standings. So hopefully I won that championship that I was well known to getting some. So I'll give you a sample of one of the races I did, which was the British Grand Prix. So I started 12th, fell back a little bit, and then worked my way up, and then it was smooth sailing from there. But that's what F1 race is all about. You'll be having setbacks throughout a race, and then having to work the whole race trying to get there. So seeing that the leader's gonna run away from it. So that's all I can say, but that's how I set up the 25% race length for most of my F1 videos. So yeah, this one's 13 laps, to be honest, and really, I really enjoyed it compared to NASCAR, though. So gotta present road course with a challenge, basically, because road course was basically my background when I played Mario Kart. So yeah, then NASCAR, yeah. NASCAR just going around in circles. I don't know why, but it just picked me up at a young age. So in some of the video clips or some of the races, you might see me using the flashbacks because I want to do well in the points. So don't want to be crashing out of these races in a way that I don't want to be cheated on or be portrayed upon, knowing that you guys might share my video, and if I know that, see that video right there? Yeah, I just spun out on my own. Whew. We're like 3 minutes into this video, so what am I gonna s- So basically, I do one pit stop for each of the 25% race length races. Whenever I do have a good car, I might stay out a little bit longer. But if my race ain't going well, I might short pit and try to gain back that track position. So basically, there's no safety car. Yeah, there is only local yellow flags, because that's how the game works, or that's how I do most of the career mode settings like that. And then sometimes you can't change it, knowing that if you put it up to 50% or 100%, then the safety car won't be deployed, because you know, it can get tiring sometimes to watch a whole video for an hour and not get any substance out of it. So that's what the purpose of this video clip is all about. Just trying to get that good content out there. So I did a comparison, not like a comparison video, but like there's these two motorsports games that are coming out on the same day, which is NASCAR Heat 5 and F1 2020, and they're coming out on July 10th, 2020. So there's still going to be the COVID-19 going on, but it happens, you know. We got to make choices in life, and knowing if you want to save money on the new next-gen games for the Xbox Series S, which is my console, you don't have to do much. I'm just here to get the new Forza Motorsports game that is coming out. So basically, I don't have much to say about this career mode. So I'm AK Happy Carlo 9. Sit back, relax, and enjoy the rest of this 1 hour lengthy video. So goodbye and peace out.
Go now. Pit strategy complete. See these tires. red is 3.8 seconds. Fuel target is plus one. Faster engine modes are available. This is your final lap of the race. Great drive. We're really happy with that performance.
So as I say that, we can see the drivers coming out now to collect their trophy. And now let's take a look at the driver's standings. Lewis Hamilton takes the lead of the Drivers' Championship. And now I'd like to ask you, Anthony Davidson, who was your driver of the day?
I have to give it to Brendan Hartley. Consistency, good battle, sensible driving.
Good day today. Tell us about it from your perspective. You must be thrilled to be up on the podium. You've been overtaken in the championship. Are you feeling the pressure? Great! Well, that's everything.
Commiserations on that result. It's been a tough weekend.
We'll be right back. lap we'd like, but don't worry about it. Just means more fun for us tomorrow.
So qualifying is complete and we're all set.
Laps of fuel remaining. work. You did well today. I think the boss will be happy with that one.
Welcome then to the podium, our top three drivers. What a great... And after this round of the World Championship, here's how things look in the drivers' table. Ali takes over the lead of the Drivers' Championship. Moving on to the driver of the day then. Anthony Davidson, who would you go for?
I'm going to go for Sebastian Vettel. People have suggested before that he can't race wheel to wheel, but as he showed today, it's nonsense.
And here's how things are shaping up in the Constructors' Championship.
Amazing performance out there. You must be really happy. You really cut your way through the field today. What was your strategy? Another podium. You must be getting used to it up there. First in the championship. How does that feel? It was more like Dodgems than Formula One today, wasn't it? Great! Well, that's everything.
We'll be right back.
fastest lap of the race. Keep this up. Chance of taking the position. Come on, we know you can do it. Box this lap, please. Thank you. position. They should last a while yet, so don't worry about them. The gap behind us is 3.9 seconds. this, we'll need to lower our ERS deployment mode. Just ahead of you. Pass. race on this compound. laps of fuel remaining. Well today. I think the boss will be happy with that one.
So as I say that, we can see the drivers coming out now to collect their trophies. So then, it's time to see how this result affects the Drivers' Championship. Well, the gap at the top of the championship has been cut down after a difficult race today for our championship leader. Moving on to the driver of the day then. Anthony Davidson, who would you go for?
I have to give it to Ali. Look at where they finished compared to...
Good day today. Tell us about it from your perspective. You gained a lot of positions during the race, didn't you? You must be happy with the result today. Appreciate your time.
Just wanted to say congrats on the podium. It's thoroughly deserved. But you brought it home.
We've received invitations to new historic events. You'll be able to choose whether or not to participate before the end of this weekend. Remember to select a driver that you consider your rival from the rivalry screen on the workstation. I think seeing as it's the end of the season, now is a good time to talk about your less than ideal record this year. My job is to negotiate on your behalf, but you're not giving me much to work with here. Plus, this isn't exactly doing my career any good, so I need you to shape up, for both our sakes. It's time for us to renegotiate your contract. Here you can see the current deal. Once negotiations begin, the team will make you an offer. You can accept if you like, but I strongly suggest we push for better terms. We're asking for too much here. We need to make some compromises. Okay, that proposal looks good. It seems all parties are happy with the deal, so it'll commence at the next race weekend. Remember to select a driver that you consider your rival from the rivalry screen on the workstation. Performing well against your rival can earn you respect and better terms when it comes to our contract reviews.
So we're coming to the end of my YouTube video clip right now, so if you're new to the YouTube community for my channel, HappyCarlin9, you can click on the bell button to subscribe to my new content each week, like my video with the thumb button, or the thumbs up button, or you can just drop a comment below the description below. So, I'm HappyCarlin9, and you all have a great day. Goodbye. Peace out.